Hey guys! We're Igrub and Pimsy, and welcome back to Elden Ring.
And Coda is on.
Coda is on Pimsy's feet.
Yes.
So last time, we went down underground to Shioffa River. We saw Blythe around here.
Yep.
We were trying to do the whole thing with Rani's, you know, quest line.
We killed a god.
We killed a god. We killed the ancestral spirit. I don't think we killed a god necessarily.
We did. We killed the god with the badass and the sword.
What?
Over, you know where the Oracle Bubble was, the big one?
The big Oracle Bubble.
He was badass, he was huge.
You're talking about the Dragonkin Soldier. That wasn't a god, that was a soldier. No, he didn't
look
like a god.
Dragonkin Soldier then.
Alright, anyway. So, we tried doing Shioffa River, but
we
apparently...
tried to kill a god, Radahn.
Yes. Radahn is a demigod, yes. So, anyway. But... because Radahn is related to Rani, because obviously they're demigods, we have to beat Radahn and then things will change to do the Eternal City of Nokron, I believe. In the meantime, I went ahead and upgraded the Sword of Night and Flame to +5. And
that's
this,
a faith weapon as well.
It is, and this weapon is amazing. It is the most damaging weapon I have at 420. The Moon Veil is also at +5, and that's only at 360. So I think... because it has three separate damage types, that's where most of the extra damage comes from. So yeah, so the Moon Veil is useful because it causes blood loss buildup.
Yeah, but it does better magic as well. So I guess if you have a higher scaling.
Yes, it does have a higher scaling in both Dex and Int. So if you have better intelligence, then it'll do more. But also, yeah, it has different uses because it does blood loss buildup. So you can actually cause blood loss to happen. Mm-hmm. Whereas the Sword of Night and Flame is just a straight, you know, does more damage thing. But also, when testing out the special stuff, this spell pierces through enemies. So it doesn't hit them and just stop, it goes through them. So you can actually hit people behind.
Really good.
And also...
because that's one of the reasons why I like the Arc spell, because it pierces through.
It's a bit finicky in terms of its range and how far it goes, but yeah, otherwise it's pretty good. Also, this one is very wide. And it does a lot of damage as well, as you can imagine.
So good for clearing out the cattle.
Mm-hmm. So the Sword of Night and Flame has a lot mixed damage, so the real damage is a little bit lower. True, but in general, if enemies are not specifically resistant to magic or fire, then it will do more damage overall, because that's how it works. So, yep, we're going to go ahead and try and take out Radahn. We were very close to beating him last time, like it was literally just one hit. Yes, that was me. We got him to basically one hit away of doing it, but I figured, yeah, you know what, we can leave it until another time. So we just need to go ahead and trigger this again.
We haven't tried out the new spells you got either.
I did try the new spells actually. So we got Loretta's Great Bow, which is okay. It's good that you can do it on a horse. We might as well rewatch this again actually.
Go on, you were saying.
So it's decent because you can use it on a horse, but otherwise it's kind of okay. It's a big magic damage shot.
Well, the bubbles ones.
The bubbles are terrible. They are actually awful. They are tiny, they do basically no damage, and they're slow as well. So,
General
yeah, it's not worth it.
Is cursed ever to wander.
Yeah, I figure this is a cool intro cutscene. Might as well watch it again.
Inside, by Melania's scarlet rot, his wits are long gone.
I hope he beat that horse.
I don't know whether he does.
Now he gathers the corpses of former friends.
The cat is watching this and he's like,
like a dog.
You guys can't see this, but the cat is literally like, at the screen. Blow, I'm angry!
Howling at the sky. So it is now night time, so the things should be open.
Howls at the sky. Right?
I didn't actually test
now
whether you can
merry.
Go through the door when it's daytime, but I think you do have to talk to Jeren to initiate the nighttime thing, and then you can start going through. Actually, I've gone the wrong way.
You have.
Please go through here first. There we go. And the lift is down, so I need to bring it back up.
You should probably just keep it up.
Well, no, because if I go back to the Stake of Marika, I never have to use lift. I just respawn at the Stake of Marika. So yeah, like I said last time, we got him very close to being beaten, but, you know, didn't quite happen. And I thought, yeah, we'll do it again next time. Loretta's Great Bow is an okay PvP spell because you can hold the fire as long as you want. You can wait to catch people out of their roll. Yeah, I think it says that you can do that, actually. So you just hold it and you stay, you know, with the arrow knocked. But you can't move if you're not on horseback, so it's not that useful. Because they'll just charge up towards you and get you. So, yeah, let's go ahead and try out Radahn. So, we are on version 1.04.1, but that hasn't made Radahn any easier or harder. So.
What did they update?
So the update to 1.04.1 is just an update to be a bug fix. It didn't make Radahn easier or harder. It's literally just fixing a couple of things. One thing I thought was interesting is that it says it fixed when some bosses die in unintended circumstances. So I was like, I have no idea what that means, but sure, I'll take your word for it from some.
I guess they said that to avoid spoilers.
Yeah, I guess. I think it's more like a... We didn't intend for this boss to fall out of the world, but it happens and we fixed it now.
So. Oh, I wonder if that's... Right, I actually know a boss that might be that.
Might be what?
Well, somebody discovered that you can actually... There's a certain boss in a certain castle. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to tell you anymore because I don't think you know yeah. where this is. But basically, you can actually come out of the castle. And the boss literally climbs out the castle and then falls to its death.
I see.
So I don't know whether that's the one that they're referring to or whether maybe. It's something else.
Maybe, maybe not. So I guess I'll try out the Sword of Night of Flame to begin with. To
that's
see
why he
like.
Can tank it, because he's got heals.
Heals?
Yeah, not Radahn. Oh, what's his name?
Who?
The wolf.
Blythe.
Blythe, that's right.
Yeah. So, the thing with Radahn is, we've spoken before about how it's basically a cinematic fight, right? It's not actually supposed to be difficult. So I'm kind of wondering, what was it that was so hard about him before?
Like, are you not doing blood loss then?
It'll take some time to switch between, so I'm just attacking while I can. But yeah, it's like, they made him so hard to begin with that they had to nerf it. But what was it that was so hard about him? Like.
Probably
was it because he did so much damage? Was it, you know, something else?
No, he had more health, they said.
More health.
But I can't remember what else it was. I think he did a lot of damage and he didn't take a lot. I think that Ooh, was the problem. So they
that?
Nerfed both of them.
Yeah. So off he goes.
Right, are you going to swap now?
In a minute. I think if I do this...
I don't have time.
Well, we'll see. Come at me, Radahn!
You're actually not swapping to a better thing. You dodged okay. with Prometheus methodology.
Well, I did it specifically because it have this increased damage negation from the flask that I used. But it doesn't protect 100% of the damage, it just significantly reduces it. Because otherwise it would have been a one-shot.
Okay.
Maybe, maybe not, I'm not sure. So. Oh, the other problem with using the Sword of Night of Flame is that the special unique skills are pretty slow.
Yeah.
So we'll just go underneath him. Oh, that actually... So I was blocking that entirely, but it skipped out because he's so big. There we go. So, right now... He moved out of the way, unfortunately.
Yeah, it makes sense. If somebody's underneath you with a flaming sword, you would move too.
Yeah, so the range is obviously not going to work very well compared to...
Confidence of this man. He says, yeah, it shouldn't take long. I'll get it on my first go.
I didn't say I'd get it on the first go. Just I said it shouldn't take long.
I think you should change the reveal.
Yeah, I probably will do. Because the blood loss is...
good, yeah.
It's very, very good.
One time you got him down way below half.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember?
Yeah, I know. I got him to within one hit of killing him.
Before he even zooped away,
yeah.
Yeah.
So they probably did a speedrun glitch bug fix. You can finish the game by glitching in just a few minutes if you know how. Radahn used to have more HP, more damage, and fatter hitboxes, so he was really hard to dodge. You couldn't dodge the arrows on horseback. They were much quicker.
Huh.
Okay. Fair enough. Let's go there and then...
Were too many people not able to kill him then? Is that why they nerfed it?
I don't know.
They must gain analytics of it.
Oh yeah, well, it's
how many
basically
times
trophies.
Is this person?
Yeah.
But
they clearly intend
no,
for
baby.
You to try
no,
doing
on.
This fight come with
on.
The summons,
there,
which is why there's so many of them.
Away from there, come on.
So,
come on, bugger.
Let's go ahead. Actually, you're more of an issue than he is at that point.
sorry.
Because I know what spells I've got on currently. But...
I'm sorry, Rob. I thought you best not have him sitting there.
That's fine.
Good boy.
Alright, so we got Bly then.
Bly down here.
Go whoosh. And that's a different arrow spell. Go over here. Got Alexander in. I imagine those arrows probably did more stamina damage and things like that. Oh, also, the other thing is, apart from the Sword of Knights and Flame, I also upgraded the Brass Shield, because you can make shield better in this game.
I thought you said that it does just improve the damage.
No, it improves the guard boost, which means that it takes less stamina when you block a hit.
Oh, right. Well, I haven't really used shield damage.
Yeah. But it's obviously very useful for some people that do that.
Most people use shield.
Yep.
I'm just stubborn. I also don't like to get close to anybody.
You stay far away from me.
Yes. Not just to pick up games, also to real life.
And the other thing is that there's obviously lots of stuff going on here. So it's like, it feels like it's supposed to be a very hectic battle.
Oh yeah, you did blood loss there.
Yes, I did.
That was so
And I
much
think
damage.
He's posture broke. No, he's not. He's just doing something. And yeah, because it's so chaotic about what's going on, it's really hard to see when he's actually going to get damaged with some things and not. But this is a posture break, so.
Good.
He's out.
Did you put on the successful hits thing?
Yes, yeah. I'm using the Winged Sword Talisman for successive hits.
I think it's
hits.
Really good for your method of doing it. Dodge to the bloody left. There, see? Did you get hit once?
I don't know. I intentionally got hit the first time when I tried it.
Why?
Because I wanted to see how much of the damage negation it actually was.
And why did you dodge?
That sucks.
No,
because
you
no, I didn't dodge the first time.
Yeah.
I didn't. I let him hit me. Yeah.
That explains a lot. Shoot him. That's it.
There we go. Radahn's dead.
You're just like, yeah, casual.
So, we have Radahn's Great Rune and Remembrance of the Star Scourge. And he gives 70,000 runes as well.
About as much as the... Dragon... Now, if you've been sensible, you would have put on the Pickled Alpha.
I guess, but I might not have had time to do it. Maybe on the second phase transition.
Right, so this is where the world changes because the stars are now
moving.
Realigning. This is cool.
Yeah.
All the NPCs die. Can you imagine?
Okay. Well, I thought I was going to stay there. Ooh. All right. So yeah, Radahn was hard, for sure one of the hardest bosses in the Soulsborne game.
No more.
Yeah, well, you know, we never got a chance to fight him in his original form.
In his true incredibility.
Yeah, and I never really felt he was as difficult as, let's say, you know, Guardian Ape in Sekiro, for example. Demon of Hatred, Ishin Ashina, those all seem to be, like, they were meant to be hard, but...
Man and Butterfly.
Yeah, but no, I don't think Radahn was intended to be a difficult boss. So. Alright, how's it going, Bly? Let's put the lantern on, shall we?
Ah, good. I was waiting for you. What a sick way to fight. The glory of the clash is shared. By Radahn. And you. And did you see that afterwards?
Yeah,
falling
the fireworks
right
play.
Before our eyes. I can't fathom how Radahn was holding back something of that scale. He was a living legend if ever I saw one. And the path has now been cleared. To Nokra. Where Rani's fate will be decided.
Okay.
Let's meet where the falling star bit the earth. We'll take up our swords once more. For Mistress Rani.
Okay. Anything else?
Let's meet where the falling star. We'll go
meet where the falling star.
To fight for Rani's fate, sword and fang. The curtain's rising. On the final act.
Okay. I think he says that because technically Radahn would be maybe the second and only required Great Rune Shard Bearer to be killed, I guess? Maybe. Alexander, how's it going?
Ah, hello there.
It was a battle. He's cracked.
Mm-hmm.
You are well and truly a champion, friend. I, on the other hand, am nothing but a crock. One hit was all it took to crack me, and for my insides to come spilling out. After that, I hid like a coward. And as such, I can hardly stand to face one such as you.
Oh, don't feel bad. You helped out.
But don't you think I've given up just yet? As luck would have it, there's a veritable mountain of warriors' bodies right here. If I can just squeeze this bunch down inside me, I'll be a mighty warrior again in no time. And you know, the bodies found here are exceedingly fine. Who could expect any less from the very warriors who fought in the Shattering, the greatest of all wars? Just you wait and see, friend.
Oh, no.
I'll grow even stronger. Just you wait when next we meet.
But Alexander's just washed people juice.
Yeah. Well, he's a living jar.
Yeah, well, I didn't know he was loads of washed people.
Just you wait.
Well, we can have a look at the description of the jar shard, can't we?
What the hell is the Kool-Aid man?
Where would jar shard be? It's down... Oh, I guess it's not. Where would it be? I forget what category it's in. But yeah, I think something along the lines of...
It'll be in a craftable one.
I guess so. So this is Remembrance of the Star Scourge. Radahn, hewn into the Erd Tree, the pirate's namesake. So
that'll give us his weapon, definitely.
Maybe. The Red Lion General wielded gravitational powers which he learned in Celia during his younger days. Also, he would never have to abandon his beloved but scrawny steed.
Maybe... We can either get his sword or the spell that's the swords that fall from the sky.
Probably one of the two, yes. I imagine it's the giant swords he has or using gravitational magic.
Before you sit, shall we just have a scour around?
And see if there's anything else.
Pop your map and we'll see.
Don't think they appear on the map. Right, okay, I have to sit out of a sight of grace
first. That's fine, but let's just have a quick look because patches might be...
I don't think
around and finger readers.
Theralina might be around because we did talk to her before the fight, but Patches, I don't know. I'm still not even entirely sure why Patches even appears there.
Probably to try and rob you.
Maybe. Yes, Radahn is also optional, and every pot is full of bodies. Yeah, because they're living jars.
God, that massive one must be really full.
Yes, and that's probably why Alexander looks up to him so much. Now, I'm not going to explore every inch of this Wailing Dunes because I know there's not... It's going to be a giant area and there's not going to be much here. But
you want to go to... Are you not going to light the bonfire then?
No, I'll go to the bonfire in a minute, but I want to see...
Sorry, the grace.
Yeah, the site of grace. I want to see what we can see from the boat, but I don't think there's anything else. Because the only thing of interest, really, is the site of grace, the two people... And then that, which I think might even be on the map. Well, I'm not sure, but it doesn't look like there's anything here, actually.
I think it is on the map.
So, let's see. Oh,
no,
it's not. Oh, I was thinking of these boats up here.
Yeah, but that's not on the map.
No, it's not. But now that we have access to the Wailing Dunes, we might be able to find...
Are you going to go across to that
catacombs.
Bit, or are you going to come back later? Go to that bit, go to the Grace, and we'll go back there.
Yeah, we'll go to the Grace. But yeah, so there's a statue that's up there that points down, and we might be able to get to that now.
Maybe we should put some markers then where it's pointing. Oh, actually, no, I think your markers are already set for what you want to do, aren't they?
I think I can put a couple more on. Mm. And I'm not seeing Theralina anywhere, so...
Yeah, I can't see her either. No, stay with me.
Just make sure she's not over on the other side of the hill.
I couldn't see her.
No, okay. Yes, there is a dungeon at the northern part of the boss arena, but nothing more than that, I think. Yeah. Makes sense. So, go ahead and sit. Maybe. I don't know.
probably talk to them again. No,
no, no talk to
Elena. Are you going to put the new...
Do I have to go to the finger reader to do it?
I don't think so.
No, it's here. I need to switch this around, actually, so... There we go. So, Radahn's Great Ruin, devoid of any benediction.
How do you get to...
Seek the Divine Tower of Caelid, which stands upon the precipice of the Dragon Barrow Shore.
Yeah, we haven't activated it yet. Yeah.
Alright, so we need to go and do that.
Yeah, okay, in Caelid.
Fair enough. Well, we know where that is, actually.
Yeah, true. Okay,
Why is the...
Because it sends you back, but you don't want to. You want to go and find the
catacombs. I guess it sends us back to...
Oh, everybody's gone. Open up your map and see where they've moved to.
I don't think they'll be here.
Ah, don't lick my hand.
So, Alexander would be around here, I guess, but we haven't found him there.
Not necessarily.
And then Blythe, in theory, would be around here. Or, depending on where the Falling Star hit, it could be around here, maybe. But we don't know, and it's going to take us a while to get around there,
I think. Is that Pidgeot?
Yeah, Pidgeot.
Yeah. I remember. Okay.
So.
We want to go that way.
I do, but I want to level up first.
Okay.
So we'll go ahead and level up.
You said you were going to do intelligence.
I was, because I needed to get the Knight of Sword and Flame up.
But
I think I might just do Vigor.
Good.
What? There is nothing that I need more intelligence specifically for yet.
There is. You use spells. You wanted to do spells. Do you not want to do that anymore?
No, I can do them. So I need 10,000 to level up again. So I'll do that.
No, just wait until you've done the catacombs.
No, because I might lose the 18,000.
Yeah, well, just sit down at the grace and then you can go and get it back.
No, I can't even use it anyway. Never mind.
Worrying for naught.
So yeah. So Radahn used to be a lot harder. I didn't think they intended him to be that hard, which is why he got nerfed. If they do indeed make him harder again, I don't know what they'll do to try and balance it. Well, Sekiro did get an update to say it had a boss rush mode. And I think having a boss rush mode in Elden Ring would be really cool. Oof. But I don't know whether they'll go ahead and do that. Because there are a lot of bosses in this game.
Alright, are we going to scour the edge or not?
I don't think there'll be anything specifically at the edge. It's more about, I know up there there's a guardian golem that we've not killed, but it doesn't give us anything interesting, so that's why we didn't do that.
I think I killed it.
You killed it, but that's how I know it doesn't give you anything interesting. Mm. Apparently they might drop their weapons, but...
But it's a random drop.
It's a random drop, yeah.
Didn't you pick up a weapon from one of them?
I'm pretty sure
you did. You picked up something from one of them. Didn't you pick up their bow?
The Guardian Great Bow, maybe?
I think so. Why are you going to put me in the inventory?
Well, I'm trying to find the catacombs.
Alright, but you can just quickly do it. There's nothing here.
Well, I don't know where the catacombs would be, which
probably
is the
there.
Point. Where's
well, have a
there?
Look at the cliffs down there. Have a look at where the statue was pointed.
So the statue... Oh, it's actually a lot further behind me. So it was probably where the pillars were.
I really can't fucking see
it. There it is, yes.
Alright, okay. So it was exactly where I thought it was.